Hello, my name is Bianca Denise Las Piñas, and me and my groupmates will tell you about the problems and issues young people face in their adolescence. So, let's get right to it.
So we all know that the society often sees teenagers as carefree and unproblematic. Us adolescents are expected to have good physical and mental health. However, due to puberty and other problematic topics, the adolescents thus face problems as well. So let's get right to our first problem. Adults are often insensitive to your feelings. Thus, the adults around you refuse to put an effort into understanding you and your feelings, or they don't see things from your point of view. Instead of being considerate and empathetic, they don't seem to care about your feelings at all. They don't think about how their words or actions might affect you or how it might make you feel. They don't listen to your opinion, and if you try to speak up, they will interpret it as mood swings or being immature. They expect you to be grateful and go along with everything they want because they are older than you or they think it's for your own good. For the second problem, the idea of perfect. Teenagers these days are so obsessed with the idea of being good at everything. They don't allow one single flaw in their work, themselves, their grades, or their reputation, which results in them beating themselves up when they make one single mistake. They are often labeled as an overachiever, a good student, a people pleaser, a pushover, a try hard, and many more. The reason for this behavior may be the result of parental expectations or societal expectations. They may have experienced the look of disappointment from the people who expected too much from them. They have this false idea in their head that being wrong is a fate worse than death. Now on to our third problem, lacking of self-love. Being a teenager means you face an awful lot of insecurities. We all know that the media has a lot of negative contents in it, and teenagers consume social media on a daily basis, so it's unavoidable for us to encounter the negative parts in it. We see these strangers on our phone, and as we scroll through Instagram or TikTok, we gradually start to think why we are not like them. Why don't I look like her? Or why does my voice sound far from his? Or should I lose weight? Those questions start to occupy our minds the whole day, and we start to invade them. For our fourth problem, we feel inadequate. Feeling inadequate is a feeling that many teenagers have had. When they are not appreciated by someone they love or care about, they believe they are not good enough for someone, their parents, friends, society, or even themselves. Every time they do something to make their parents proud, the fear strikes them. Whatever they do or say, they feel they are somehow always wrong. They have always been blamed for everything. Even if they tried their hardest to do better, to catch their attention, or acknowledge their work, their parents would always find a flaw in their hard work and never acknowledge the effort they put into something. Now, on to our fifth and final problem. Generational trauma. Generational trauma is exactly what it sounds like. Trauma that isn't just experienced by one person, but extends from one generation to the next. It can be silent, covert, and undefined, surfacing through innocence and inadvertently taught or implied throughout someone's life from an early age onward. Many things get passed down through families, like heirlooms, genetic conditions, and physical characteristics. In some cases, trauma can be inherited too.
Hey, are you okay?
No, I'm not.
What happened?
It's just that I have this generational trauma.
Generational trauma is a kind of trauma that passes from generations to generations, and that explains that just like my great-grandfather, he experienced Holocaust in Germany in times of Adolf Hitler, and I'm just really afraid that it will happen again. Like, I'm extremely afraid.
Mm-hmm. The solution for this problem is that you should stop trying to please them. Start setting and enforcing boundaries. Know that you are not too young to give your opinions, and don't be afraid to speak up. The solution for this is that you should allow yourself to make mistakes. Stop humbling yourself and start actually appreciating your efforts. Have realistic expectations. Start accepting that having flaws are normal, and don't mind the people who think otherwise. And always remember that you are enough. The solution for this problem is that you should stop comparing yourself to others. Stop trying to become someone you're not. Take your time out of social media and treat yourself. See your insecurities as a unique trait about yourself and appreciate every single thing about your body and your being. The solution for this problem is to never stay in any situation that makes you feel inadequate. We also need to understand what kind of individual is making you feel worthless. And the most important way to get rid of those people is to control yourself from thinking about their opinions on you and whatever you are doing. You have to start appreciating what you achieved and don't build your whole self-esteem on other people's reactions. The solution for this problem is that you should become aware of these destructive patterns. Educate yourself about your family history. Talk to your parents about it so that you and your family can go to therapy together. And make sure that this generational cycle stops with you.